everyone, this is CthuLuigi, and welcome to part 3. Let's play Super Mario Brothers Deluxe. Right now, the Deluxe is just a little awkward, but it's gonna be a lot of fun when I'm saying, hello everyone, this is CthuLuigi, welcome to part X of Let's Play Super Mario Advance 3, Super Mario World 2, Yoshi's Island, and because that sort of thing never gets old, I'd probably end up listing, like, the world and level number 2 in the part of the title. Just, I don't like this. Okay, I'm not gonna try to do anything in this level. I'm just gonna friggin' get past it so I don't have to. Why is there water? This game is making me upset. Or maybe it's the fact that I've had nothing to eat in the past times but a bunch of Valentine's candy and cake. What? I didn't know that happened. This game is weird. I always think it's a little surreal to imagine that. I always think it's a little surreal to imagine that people actually had to play things like this and, like, didn't have internet. Actually, it just greatly distresses me to ever think of Aero without internet. I hope that I am not alone in this. I can't imagine I'm not. Of course, at the same time, what 90% of the population considers the internet isn't really valid. It's like my cube or whatever you guys are doing now, where you just text message on a computer. That's not what the internet is for. The internet is, for pretending that you're one of the people I just mentioned and using it to annoy other people. I'm not even gonna try to make sense of this game. I have no skill in it. It's sort of just like, this is the kind of game that you could probably beat with a mathematical formula instead of, like, thinking about it. Just, like, I think it would be pretty easy if you had a programming language that understood the commands and stuff. Just, like, if pipe equals near Mario, note if Parama plant will be out at time of jumping, and just the sort of thing. It seems more like a series of calculations with graphical representations than a video game. I'm so used to, like I said, I was playing Super Mario World earlier, and I've been watching a bunch of videos of Super Mario World, so I keep expecting the shells to behave like they behave in Super Mario World. And why do the mushrooms look so weird in this? I guess they just didn't. No, I guess they just didn't really want to put too much effort into it, because the video games were sort of a dying industry still back then. And because the concept art of mushrooms has always looked sort of freaky. It's like they're smiling and have inverted colors and stripes and stuff. Oh, I didn't know I could go in that. I bet a bunch of people who are actually familiar with Super Mario Brothers were sort of incredibly pissed at me for not going in here. And now people who are capable of pressing the A button with any amount of timing are pissed at me for missing that block a million times. Alright, so now I don't have to deal with that first part again. Ooh, a star. I'm just, like, finding a boatload of things to annoy people who played the game before with missing every star. I thought that was, like, a scripted thing. It would send you one place if you pressed A on it, and it wouldn't if you didn't. And I didn't think, actually, what you were doing had anything to do with it. Oh, screw it. Why is there a snowball there? And yes, it's the top of a tree. But why are the trees white? Isn't it supposed to be snowing here? We're snowing in the darkness of space? Did Bowser, that second Bowser, accidentally, like, have the key to the atmosphere machine, and now Mushroom Kingdom is completely devoid of atmosphere? I still don't know if that's a skull or a weird-looking mushroom, or both, or neither, or something. Probably neither. I still don't get why there are a bunch of little castles. Video game logic has to make perfect sense. And unfortunately, referencing the fact that video game logic doesn't make sense is about as old of a joke as just questioning video game logic, so I can't really say that without silently hating myself. So, I don't know, I should just make interesting comments like, did you know that each coin is worth 200 points? I didn't until I just looked up now, I would have put my money on 100. And that star was not very well hidden, and I can follow it over here to make it last longer, and I am so horrible at the game, I'm not going to attempt much more than that! I don't like that. This game can go have a wiener. In its mouth, also. I want that Koopa Troopa back. What? I didn't know I was... What? Where is this? I don't even... this game is causing me severe mental and physical trauma. I hope I can get through world or level 3-3 before this video ends. Alright, 1-up, who's the man? It's gonna bounce back and kill me! Looks, doesn't, scary. I wanna spin jump, why can't I spin jump? Games that were made, like, within not a few years of my birth were horrible by that virtue. Except that one game, I don't know how many people are familiar with Feeding Frenzy, but there's some Intellivision game that is a horribly pixel version of that. Actually, Feeding Frenzy is probably just an advanced version of some moderate type game that's I don't know of. I always like the games basically where you're just trying to eat things and grow big and eat bigger things and whatnot. Except sometimes they're just flash-based ones, and because it's simpler that way, they, like, there's just, like, a bunch of giant things all the time and then a bunch of insignificant specks and you grow up by weird amounts and if you're... Oops, I didn't know that was the one that fell, or I knew it was the one that fell, and I tried to save myself by not even staying on it. That way it wouldn't fall. But back to my completely irrelevant ranting. It annoys me when the games where you are like a fish or some kind of horrible monster eating other fish or horrible monsters, and they're just like random integers. I do not, just because I am a math person doesn't mean I get to use the word integer whenever I mean some kind of number. Just, yeah, like a randomly generated number that its size is multiplied by. That is, that is not how it should work. There should be specific types and probably different levels, and because other than that, it's too hard to tell and it gets boring and... I'm talking about Flash games. What is wrong with me? But anyway, the only good Flash games try to make you pay for them, and I'm not paying for anything on the internet. That's what communists do. Ah, man, maybe I am gonna be able to finish this level and this part. I only have, like, extremely vague remembering... remembrance? What? I don't know what word I'm looking for. Maybe it is remembering. Ah! Memory. Yes, memory sounds better. Of how this level is laid out, so I don't know if it's hard or not. I already am at flamey breath at me, so I am assuming I might be able to beat this without a bunch of deaths, which would honestly shock me. Ah, what's happening? This isn't right! Yes, yes, there are princesses in another castle. It would be really wacky if someone made a joke about that. Anyone who wants any kind of video game related humor, you can take that. I'm not an artist myself, but If you want to, like, draw a comic, I don't know, anything, like, maybe Mario could get mad and say, "But I worked hard to go through that castle, it should be in that castle," and he beats up Toad, that would be comic gold, and because I don't have artistic ability, except for my wonderful voice, I will let you have the intellectual rights to that idea. So if you want to make that a comic, give me a video response or link me it or something, and I will go read it and say it is a good comic and some kind of brilliant genius designed it. And with that, I will see you next time, or we'll probably quit this streak of succeeding.